Okay, so continuing this, let's see how we do. Gonna remember Pomodoro. 25 minutes on the clock. Let's see if we can get a bit further with this. Right, so we've got a failing test, which is how we left it. So the code for the test doesn't work. And frankly, I didn't like the scoring function at all. So I'm gonna do test first, test driven development version of a scoring function. And I'm actually going to create a function here. Once I do it, so we've got a word which is a string, and we've got a guess which is a string. And it's going to return. The word squat, and we start off like that, right? So what we do is we go word equal rank, let's just start this way. And we're going to set the score of word. Don't really need that. Don't need those. Is the same. And in this case, it would be one green. Okay. Let's run this test. Two. Point index. Whoops. That's the wrong button. sure the other tests continue. Oh, I haven't got any scores. Okay, but that's okay because we're gonna. Right. So, okay. Now, in true test first design, test driven development style, what we do is we just make the simplest thing that passes the test. So, the simplest thing that passes this test is return that. And then we run the test. Great. So, the next thing is we have another. B. And we're going to put in a, that should return red, and we run the test. And again, of course, it doesn't work because green is not red and A is not B. So we actually have to write and map. So we could, if we zip, we're doing the best, and map it to if they're equal. Green. Otherwise red. So last episode, what you saw me doing was essentially thinking this through and trying to write the code. Well, this is a different way of doing it. It's like you don't really think, you just make the test pass. So, great, we've got two. Now let's try another one. What if we had A, B, and B, C? We'd expect B to be yellow. C to be red. Run the test. Of course, this will fail because we at no point do we return the yellow. So, what's happened is this, the red here needs to be yellowed. Okay. Can we just modify if so, if we do filter out. So those will be all the unmatched. Then if we've got unmatched letters, so I'm going to make a mutable version of the word and the guess. I'm going to do the same thing here. Right, so we're changing the guess, we're filtering out any unmatched, we're filtering in any unmatched letters, we should enumerate. Here, just wonder if there's an easy way to do this. So, got scored guess, enumerated, and then sort it. So, if we contain the character, then we've got a hit. So, we take the score at the index, which is the offset, and we equal it to yellow. Then we have to remove it from the word. And again, we just remove from the offset. And then right, I think that might work. So let's see if the test passes. Yay, test succeeded. So basically, we score the greens first, right? So let's do some more ones. Guessed, and that's definitely red. We don't need that scoring thing. Red. But the rest is fine. Right, I like this version of score. Should go in model. W O R D. Custom dump. Better. So we've got, because we're not doing the scores. One too many. Oh, okay. Definitely seems to be adding one. One, two, three, four, five, six. That is too many long. Mm. And this, for some reason, it is not working. Because when we append a letter, we are not changing the score. Right. Okay, so that's the next thing to do, is to update the score properly in the game reducer. It's in model test, where it should be in. This has got to be in. Game feature test. So we've got to go through the reducer to test the actual logic. It's got an additional one, so it's definitely adding one when it shouldn't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we'll figure that out next go.